Welcome to Advanced Billing Techniques. We're going to go over summarized time and material for AIAs, segregating fee out at the bottom of an AIA and showing it at the bottom of the AIA, and how to use progress billing, but get a report out of the system that shows an over-under based on costs. So first, we're going to hit the summarized time and material for the AIA. So we're going to go into the project contract setup. So you're going to set up the contract header pretty much just like normal, nothing too crazy up here. We're going to set up our contract lines. We're going to look at one of these, and I'll explain this, the difference here. So you're going to set up the top part here, just like a time and material basis. You're going to set up time and material here, like you normally would, with the summarize checkbox on. What this does is it summarizes any costs that hit any of these cost codes that are linked to the 01 general conditions line. So all of these are linked to this line on the AIA. So this will come out on the AIA, the 01 general conditions summarized for all those costs. If you want the rate to flow through at the line level, the 01 general conditions line level, you're going to put the rate table on as well. And if you want a schedule of values amount on the general conditions, you'd put 50 grand here. Okay. And then you have another line as well. You know, you'd have all your schedule values lines similar to that line I was showing. So when you go to bill this project, so time and material summarized, got my AIA form. That's what that one is. I'm going to hit preview. We're going to scroll down here. And you can see the summarized costs that have hit the line items here for my summarized time and material lines. So 01 general conditions, the checkbox was on the setup I showed you, 02 as well. And I've got my related accounts payable bills. So the 01 cost codes, the 02 cost codes that summarized. So these two amounts and these two amounts summarize up here into the respective lines. Okay. So you can adjust and take off, you know, a line if you want to. It's going to adjust it up here. And you can also adjust your prices down here as well. Also, you can adjust it in total up here. Okay. So don't recommend too often adjusting in total up here, because you'll lose visibility as to what you were adjusting when you look back and want to look at the history of why you adjusted something. Okay, so it's better to adjust it at the line level, so you know you decrease forward metals, for example. Okay, so just a little tip there. But you can do it if you want to. So once we've got to the screen and the costs have generated into the lines, you can adjust like I showed you, but we're going to push this through as it is. And we're going to go look at invoice 78 and look at the printout. So you can see the 16,000, the retainage held. And then you can see our detailed lines, and it summarized those four accounts payable bills into each line as it showed on the previous screen. Okay, so this is the final output if you set up the time and material to summarize appropriately. Okay, so it helps with getting your costs through to the AIA without having to pull reports and try to figure out, you know, how much I need to put on line one and line two. The system will do it automatically for you. Okay. Now let's go over to a setup where you would want a fee to show at the bottom of the AIA, but using the summarized time and material approach. Okay, so we're going to navigate over to the project contracts again. And we're going to look at the lines on this project. So same setup as the other one. We're going to go into here and look at the O1 general conditions. It's still going to be time and material summarized to get the cost to flow through for all of the costs that would hit these cost codes. Only the costs, no rate table. Okay, so same setup as far as time and material needs to be billing type here and summarize as well. Otherwise, you take the rate table out and you could do everything else the same. Okay, so we don't want the fee on the lines. We want the fee at the bottom. That's why we're not doing the rate table. Okay, so we're going to put the fee at the bottom here. And we're going to call it a progress bill billing type. Okay, so got everything else the same. You can put there's a schedule of values line amount in there if you want. The caveat to this is that the fee does not automatically calculate. You type the fee in. So if you want the fee segregated out from your costs at the bottom of the AIA, you will need to type that in on the next step in the next screen when you generate invoices. Okay, so when you come in here to generate invoices, in preview, you're going to type your fee in this section. So this is where normal progress billing lines will come into this generate invoices screen. So your costs for general conditions and demolition for summarized T&M are down here, and you can see all your costs right here. No markup. You scroll up, you can make adjustments like I've shown or make them down here. And then you would put your fee in, for example, let's do like that. Okay, so then we're going to create our invoice. So we've let the costs flow through as they are. We've put a 10 grand in fee on, and we're going to create the invoice. Okay. And the output is going to look like this. So I've got my $18,440.90 plus 10 grand in fee, so 28 retainage. And we've got our line items down here with the fee at the bottom. Schedule values was 15, I billed 10, manually put that in, and you get your schedule values with the fee at the bottom. Okay, so now let's look at the progress billing with cost code mapping. So the effect of this at the end of the day is going to be a report that will show you your schedule of values line number. So if you have 01 for your schedule of values line, 02, 03, all the way down, the schedule of values line will be billed at 80 grand, but here's the related costs. Okay. So this report can be built so that it will show what you build for line one, schedule values line one, what your costs are, and your over under billing amount. Okay. So at the end of the day, we'll come back to and look at this at the end, but this is what this solution will do. The purpose of that would be if your project managers or if accounting is curious as to what your billing versus your costs are by line item on a schedule of values or an AIA. Okay. So in the system, let's look at a project contract set up similar to this way. So first of all, for progress billing, an AIA type setup, there is no cost code linking. So to get to the report that I showed, we have to do a couple of things for setup on the cost codes and on the contract lines. Okay, so you're going to set up your contract and your lines just like you would a normal AIA setup. You're going to have progress bill down here. You're going to come down here and you're going to put in a parent cost code that relates to this line. So 01 general conditions, generally speaking, goes with the 01 cost codes. Now, when you do that on the cost code side, you're going to need to set up, do some things to your project cost codes. Okay, so the project we're working with is 24005. And on that 01000 general requirements parent cost code, I'm going to put a WBS code of 01. The WBS code stands for the schedule of values line number. Okay, so 01 here, you're going to put the WBS code on. Then 01 cost parent cost code, which has that WBS code on it of 01, is going to match up with your 01 line up here. Okay, so whatever cost code you pick down here, you want it to match up with your line on your schedule of values. Okay, so let's just say for simplicity purposes that all of the 01s, all of the 01 child cost codes, so the detailed cost codes, roll up into 01 general requirements on your schedule of values. Okay, so the 02s would then roll up into the 02 line item on your schedule of values. In order to get the report to work the way that it has been built, the WBS codes need to be on the parent level. You don't necessarily need to put them below, like these show here. You just need to get it on the parent level. And then you will need to put that parent cost code here on this, on the contract line. Okay, so that when you bill and create billing through the system and generate invoices here, the report that has been built will then come out like this. So any costs that I have cost coded on an AP bill or labor, you know, any of those cost entries, if they hit these one cost codes, they're going to be grouped in the 001 or 01 schedule values line number. Okay, so the 52,200 are all my costs, and the ones that have, that are with the 01 line. The 80,000 here is what we generated through the billing process. Okay, so you can summarize this to be just show the totals. So for 01 general requirements, I've billed 80 grand, but I have 52,200 in costs. Okay. Now this second line here is a scenario where I don't want 1005 to be up in the ones, 01 schedule values line. I want it to be in the demolition area, so the 02. So we edited that specific cost code on the cost code screen to have the 00, the 02 WBS code to go to line 2. Okay, so this is a setup that can be deployed if you're looking to match up what you build for your, on your schedule values lines compared to what costs came into the system. Okay, it's not a native solution in Intacct, but we at Bingert have deployed an approach to get this information out in a report for you. So after watching this, if you have questions on any of the topics we have discussed in these, the certain billing techniques or billing setups, feel free to reach out to us and we would be more than happy to further assist.